I think my favorite part about Civil War is when Vision and Scarlet Witch are in the kitchen cooking. It's so epic! Are you an everyday nerd? Hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you don't miss the next episode. Yo, welcome to Everyday Nerd B-Sides Editions. I'm your host, Zach Snyder. I know the B-Sides talk about anything and everything in the same format as your Everyday Nerd. They're just shorter, unsponsored episodes. As we continue our road to Endgame, it's time to take a look at one of my most hyped films in the entirety of the MCU. This was probably the first film outside of the original Avengers that I was genuinely hyped for. Dubbed as the one Captain America movie that's actually an Avengers movie, it's time to take a look at Captain America Civil War, which was a movie that I did see in theaters when it came out, but I haven't seen it since. So let's see if it's still worth the rewatch.
This job. We try to save as many people as we can.
If you don't know anything about it, 2016's Captain America Civil War is the 13th film in the MCU and is directed by the Russo brothers. Following the events of Captain America Winter Soldier and Avengers Age of Ultron, the Avengers are in a bit of a situation due to the newly founded Sokovia Accords, a set of laws that prohibit superheroes to work unguided. In other words, the government got involved after a bunch of incidents occurred over the years and a lot of collateral damage happened. These new accords caused turmoil between the Avengers. Steve Rogers believes that they should have the freedom to operate as they have been for the last few years, while Tony Stark believes that they have operated on their own for far too long and it's time they were put in check. Meanwhile, each of these heroes have their own problems to deal with. After Winter Soldier, Bucky has realized that he has been mind-controlled by Hydra over the years. He finds Steve and they work on keeping him safe. Tony is dealing with his perpetual father issues as he finds out who exactly it was that killed his parents. Plus, he's also still dealing from PTSD from the first Avengers movie. Each hero has his own set of morals, causing them to fight against each other, bringing in other Avengers, hence the term Civil War. This film, much like the past few films, tries to do way too much. However, Civil War does a good job at keeping everything in check. On one hand, the actual Civil War debate with the Sokovia Accords is the main focus. On the other hand, this is technically a Captain America movie, which means we have to see the end of his main arc. We get a resolution to his old sweetheart Peggy from the first movie because, well, she dies. She's like 90-something. On top of that, his best friend Bucky is having his own issues, and Steve has to take the burden of resolving those at the cost of his current friendships within the Avengers. Probably the coolest part about Civil War, though, is undoubtedly the introduction of two of Marvel's biggest players in history, and that is Black Panther and Spider-Man. I was extremely surprised and ecstatic to see these characters were in the MCU. Seeing them alongside all the other heroes is something we never thought we would see, especially Spider-Man, considering he originally had his own movie trilogy with Sony and then another two movies. I think that was also Sony. And now he has another movie coming out, but with Marvel. Spider-Man's complicated. But this is why, yes, there are Captain America elements here, but at the end of the day, we are working with more of an Avengers movie. Tony plays an extremely big part in the story of Civil War. He's also the one that brings Spider-Man into all of this. But then again, the story of Civil War is more grounded than the story of Age of Ultron. We don't have, like, you know, AI fighting robots. We have Zemo, a guy who wants to use Bucky to split up the Avengers. This is why it's hard to categorize this film, because while it does perfectly fit as a Captain America movie, it also perfectly fits as an Avengers movie. Speaking of Zemo, he's definitely my favorite MCU villain at this point in the franchise. Obviously, there's much better now, but at this point, we didn't see somebody that had such grounded goals and actually made them happen. Sure, we had Loki, who was pretty good in the first Avengers, but Loki did not succeed. Zemo does. He does split up the Avengers. With that being said, my favorite part about Civil War, by far, just like the other Avengers movies, is the character interactions. I love seeing all these characters interact with each other, whether they're fighting against each other, whether they're teammates or not. This is clearly the biggest reason you're gonna want to see Civil War. Other than that though, while I do love Civil War, it's not a movie that I feel like I can rewatch a lot. I feel like a lot of what I've gotten out of it, I've already gotten out of. I mean, I did see this in theaters 3 years ago when it came out, and I never sat back down to watch it. I've owned the Blu-ray for a while now, and I just now rewatched it after all this time. Meanwhile, other films like Guardians 2, Infinity War, even Endgame, I've seen multiple times and I could still go back and watch it even more. I think the biggest reason is because I love the character interactions in this film. But if I want more character interactions like that, I can go see Spider-Man and Black Panther in Infinity War. I can go see everybody in Endgame. They do everything this movie does just better. So what does this mean for you, though? I think a lot of this, personally for me, has to do with superhero fatigue. I think I've watched all these movies in a very short span of time, tried to put out videos as fast as I could, and even my last couple MCU videos, I don't think I did that well on. I'm fortunately back, ready to talk about these movies again. But I think when it comes to Civil War, it's definitely a movie that you should watch if you haven't seen it yet. If you're watching the MCU, it's required viewing. A lot of things that happen in here with the Sokovia Accords and the character interactions and the build-up is important to the overall MCU story. If you're rewatching everything for Endgame, again, I think this is a definite watch. There's a lot of character build-up with Tony and Steve, which is super important to Endgame, and it was really nice to refresh myself on all of that. But anyways, that's all the time we have for today. If you liked the video, hit that like button. If for reason you didn't like it, hit that dislike button. Let me know down in the comments, what are your thoughts on Captain America Civil War? Are you excited for the other MCU videos? We still have a few left to go before we get to Endgame and my MCU ranking. But we also have plenty of other episodes coming out in the next couple of weeks, including what I'm really excited about, my 100th episode. This is not your regular, your everyday nerd episode. It's gonna be hype. I'm excited for it. I've already shown it to a couple of friends. They really enjoy it. So go ahead and hit that subscribe button for more episodes of Your Everyday Nerd, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.